Greetings everyone. In today's episode, I'm going to take in a little tour of the work done in certain areas of HMS Victory, and we'll be mainly focusing on the weather deck. One thing that has improved since last week is the addition of volumetric clouds, which will still be a part of the storm system that will bring rain and possibly snow onto the decks of the Victory. It is the little details, though, that bring a certain level of realism to the project as long as the computer doesn't crash and the programs continue to run well. I figured that I might make use of what I have available. As always, if you have any questions or comments, they are more than welcome. I want this to be something that not only I enjoy creating, but will be enjoyed by everyone and anyone who has a love for the Victory. Here you can see the new and improved staircase on the quarterdeck. I do want to spend some time in Admiral Nelson's dining cabin to show you the ongoing work that's been progressing along. It has been one of those areas where I feel it needs a lot of attention even still. If you're wondering about the officer's mess, it's still an ongoing build and will have future updates to come. In the meantime, I choose to focus one deck at a time and one week at a time. This is going to be a little longer video than usual, just because I want to show the work that went into smaller details. A lot of what is to be created from here on out will be a lot of the smaller details that aren't noticeable at first glance. I want to simulate the conditions as to what sailors in the 18th and 19th centuries might have had to experience when out at sea. I'm also still working on getting the ship to actually float in water so that you get the feeling of what it would be like to walk around the decks as the ship's plowing through rough seas. I'll show you what I have for the lower deck so far though. I've had to model some of the lower gun deck just because it's visible from the middle gun deck. In the demo, this deck will be off limits as well as the bowsprit. I plan to eventually work on the lower decks below the middle gun deck, but for now I'm going to fine tune the upper decks and see how far I can push the detail. Here in Blender you can see some of the issues that I've been dealing with here lately. This is one issue where you can see the beams are touching the top of the door frame, and it shouldn't be like that. There should actually be some molding that goes across the top here. If any modelers out there happen to know how to fix this, feel free to let me know. This is one issue that I've been constantly dealing with on these decks here. This is a time lapse of the chicken coop. There is actually two of these chicken coops on the HMS Victory that I'm aware of. This is just a basic model of the chicken coop. I'd still like you to be able to climb the rat lines though. And the rat lines on the poop deck are still climbable, but it's really a challenge to try and do that. And that is because of the coating. I've still been looking for an answer to the information boxes I'd like to appear in certain places on the ship. So if anyone is watching this and knows anything about Unreal Engine 4.26 and has some idea of how to do the pop-up word bubbles text boxes, please leave me a comment and let me know how to go about that. If you guys are wondering why it takes two different programs to make this work, that's because one program is where the modeling and the materials are created and applied, and the other is where things like animation, collisions, and dynamics, which include gravity, are all added. It's hard to tell from the video, but each object the player comes in contact with has to have a collision set up so that you can walk around the decks without falling through a floor or passing through an object. And it's because of this that the buoyancy becomes difficult, because when you have collisions with objects that float, the collision properties change. In this case, the ship's hull has a collision that occurs with water, but the player also has a collision with the hull as well. It is possible to have multiple collisions on an object, but it becomes more complicated when that object is being driven by dynamic objects such as water. What happens when I run the simulation with buoyancy is that the ship sinks and the player becomes non-responsive. Until I find a solution for this, the ship will have to stay in a stationary position. Here we have a time lapse of one of the rifles that is being built. I haven't included this yet in the Victory project itself. This is actually upcoming. So this is a little bit of a behind the scenes look at something that will be out in a few weeks, I hope. As it is right now, it's almost as if the ship is in dock, which is great for now, but it's not very realistic. The programming part seems to be the biggest setback so far. I know that software can handle these things, like the storms and the buoyancy, but I'm still trying to navigate through the Unreal Engine. So little by little, as I find new things or new ways of doing things, there'll be subtle changes here and there. Thank you for tuning in and for all of your continuing support on this project. If you know anyone who may be interested in learning about the Victory, please feel free to share this video. I'll see you guys next week. Hope to see you then.